Alright, welcome back to episode 3 of The Wolf Among Us. Someone just knocking on the door. It's probably like a fable or something. Let's go, like, beat somebody. I was that chick, I forgot about her.
Bigby!
Snow?
Oh,
come with me!
Snow. Snow!
What? Sorry, I'm... What is it?
What happened?
I just can't get into it this second. We need to hurry to...
Oh, no!
Hi.
Hello. Good morning. Or evening.
Yeah.
Okay.
These walls are paper thin. We need to be careful. We'll talk outside.
Wolf and Sheriff's clothing. Who's that? I wonder. I really don't know. Oh, Jesus, the cops. The head off. Or body.
You knew this girl? Is... She's not a Mundy, right?
Some one chick that you just met, that we met.
Who was she? I thought I knew everyone in Fabletown. She looks familiar. I can't place her, though.
She was a prostitute.
Really?
I never caught her real name.
Oh.
Yeah. The woodsman. He attacked her, I stepped in. And he threatened to kill us both.
No. You don't think he...
I don't think anything yet. Just give me a second.
It's just... terrible. It took me a second to realize what I was even looking at.
So, who found her?
I did. She was just like this. I didn't touch her. I grabbed Grimble's jacket to cover her with. Then, I came to get you right away.
No one else was with you?
No. Big P, did one of us do this?
There hasn't been a murder in Fabletown in a long time.
All the more reason we shouldn't start a panic before we know what's going on. Have a look around. We don't have much time before people will be coming through here.
Strange cut. What did this to her?
What could do something like that?
Either something very sharp, or something with magic attached to it.
The ex.
What is? It's her ribbon. There's some kind of symbol here.
I don't recognize it.
Neither do I. She was placed here with some care.
What do you mean?
You can see that someone didn't just toss her here. She was deliberately placed for us to find.
What kind of monster would do this? I'm sorry. This is just so surreal. What do you want to do next?
We still have some time. I should keep investigating the area.
Okay, good idea.
Blood. Drops of blood. I'd say it's been here an hour, maybe? Fabric. Looks like jeans. Doesn't tell me much.
Watch the wind chick just get taken away.
Blood. Still wet. Sharp enough. Just some loose trash.
Bro, I see you. What's that? Right there. It's freaking moving. What is that? You can see it? Black dot or something like that? I freaking see that thing.
What are you doing?
Better to be thorough.
Sure, just hurry up. We don't have much time. We should move her before anyone shows up. We'll find out more at the business office. She'll be in the books. I'm sure of it. Bigby, do you have any idea what's going on?
This is a message.
A message? I don't know, Bigby. I get complaints at the office all the time, but just what about this makes you think that?
The woodsman threatened to kill her with me in the room. Maybe he wants me to know that he did it.
I suppose it's possible. I'm gonna have to tell Crane about this. As long as King Cole is gone, he's acting mayor. He needs to know. And he's going to find out anyway, so we may as well get out in front of it. It'll just be worse if he finds out we held it from him.
Don't tell him. It'll just complicate things. I've got all the motivation I need to find out who did this.
He's the mayor.
Deputy mayor. The position's a joke.
I'll think about it.
I just don't want him interfering.
Crane's not what's important right now. We need to figure out who this girl was so we can find whoever did this. Take this back to Dr. Swinehart. He can take a look at it. I'll meet you at the business office.
Alright, looks like I'm gonna end this episode here. Catch you in the next one. Leave a like.